We hear about phishing attempts all of the time. Lance with Tech Republic here. Thanks for being with me today. You know, the holidays, of course, we are right in the middle of the shopping season and emails are going everywhere and people are trying to accommodate different groups and trying to buy gifts and all of those kind of things. And phishing attempts, unfortunately, are on the rise as we would expect this time of year. Before we get into some of the specific four phishing scams to look out for, just give us a brief overview for those who might be confused a little bit as to what phishing even is, what it looks like.
Sure, Karen. So phishing is a very common and easy tactic that a lot of cyber criminals will employ. It's easy because all you need is just a list of people to email and the ability to just create your fraudulent emails and your fraudulent landing page. So the way it works is that the bad guys will create an email that typically impersonates or spoofs a well-known company or brand or organization that the recipient might use or might be familiar with. And the whole goal, obviously, is to trick the person into clicking on a link or clicking on a file attachment. And the end goal is usually to steal the person's confidential information. Often it's account credentials, login credentials. In other cases, it might be financial information, credit card details, social security number, anything like that. And these campaigns are often so successful because the phishing emails are very convincing. And that's even more so now. In the old days, it was easier to spot a phishing email because you would find typos and grammatical errors and mistakes, and they didn't appear very legitimate or very convincing. Now, however, they're becoming much more sophisticated. In fact, I myself received a phishing email the other day, and it was from an email provider that I use, and it looked perfect. It looked legitimate. The sender's address looked real. There were no mistakes or typos in the email, so it was very convincing, and I could have seen how someone could have easily fallen for it. The only way I found out was by contacting the provider and asking them about it, and they confirmed that it was a phishing email. So these are getting trickier and more devious these days.
Yeah, and you're, tech savvy, you know to look out for these things, but most people don't, and that's the scary thing where people fall victim, especially this time of year, as I mentioned earlier, with buying gifts and things like that online. Oftentimes, these tactics, this fraudulent activity is rolled up into a shipping charge of some sort, some type of fraudulent shipping here, and that's the way that they're getting to people.
Right, exactly. So the story I wrote was about a report from this security company called GreatHorn, and they looked at some of the types of phishing campaigns that are popular, especially around the holidays. So one type of campaign, one type of attack that they discussed was a fraudulent shipping notification. And this is clear topic for the bad guys to exploit around the holidays, because with the coronavirus pandemic, fewer people obviously are shopping at physical retail stores. So we're more reliant than ever on online shopping. So what happens is these scams will impersonate notifications from companies like Amazon and FedEx and DHL. And usually they'll say something like, there's a problem with your order or a problem with your account. You please click on this link to sign in. And the goal, of course, is to get the person's account credentials for Amazon or for another company and then steal those. So GreatHorn, for each of these four types of campaigns, they also came up with a couple of pieces of advice that people would do well to remember. So one thing, some of these are kind of obvious, but always worth repeating. One thing obviously is to, when you get an email that looks suspicious in any way, shape, or form, don't click on the link, don't click on the file attachment. You can always contact the sender directly to find out whether or not this is a legitimate message from them. Another thing that you can do is to check the sender's address. And many times these scams will use generic domain names like Yahoo or Gmail or something like that, rather than a legitimate, rather than the actual company name. So that's one, that's definitely one of the biggest clues as to whether or not one of these messages would be legitimate or a scam.
And, you know, another thing, Lance, that we hear about a lot this time of year, and people have great intentions, you know, that they want to donate to different charities and for those that are looking for help during the holidays. And unfortunately, when we have the best of intentions, that's oftentimes when people are taken advantage of.
Sure. Yeah. And that's another common topic to exploit around this time is a charity or requests for donations to charities. So the cyber criminals obviously are aware that people are generally a little more giving during the holidays. So this type of scam, what they do is they will send out an email looking for donations for a particular charity. And most of the time the charity does not even exist. It's just something that they made up. And then the idea is that if you click on the link or the file attachment to give a donation, the cyber criminal then is able to get your PayPal information or other financial information, credit card details that you use to make the donation. So what GreatHorn advises as far as dealing with these types of scams, and again, this is good advice for any type of suspicious email, is to check the source. If you get a donation request for a particular charity that you've never heard of, do some research. Check it out online. See if this is a real charity or something that's made up. Another thing that you could do with these types of emails that I often do is you can take something from the email, whether it's the sender's address or some bit of text in the email, and do a search for it online, because if you're getting these types of scam messages, definitely other people would be getting them as well. And you may find some indication online that, hey, look out, this is a known scam.
Yeah, most definitely. And that one always just makes me cringe, you know, to know that criminals are taking advantage of people in a way like that and pulling around their heartstrings. Another thing, again, too, this time of year, gift cards, coupon scams, you know, easy for people to fall victim to those as well.
So this is another type of scam that GreatHorn described in their report. And the way this works is that typically the scammer will offer some kind of really great deal, fantastic deal, lowest price ever, and invite you to invite the recipient to purchase whatever this is. The catch is that they want you to purchase the item using gift cards. And gift cards are unfortunately a really known common tactic used in these types of scams, where the cyber criminal will take the gift card information and then obviously steal that for their own use. So what GreatHorn advises in terms of dealing with this type of scam is that always be on the lookout for something that sounds too good to be true, because it usually is. And if there's one of these deals or one of these emails that is asking you to enter your credit card information or your PayPal information, then definitely always think twice before that and check it out ahead of time before you take the bait.
Yeah, absolutely. And the last one that they touch on, which I more than understand why we're seeing this as people are all clawing to get out and at change of scenery. We've all been stuck at home, right? So we're looking to travel sites. I find myself looking at places, even though I'm not really going to go, but it's just like we're all dreaming of traveling this time of year and getting away, Lance. But unfortunately, travel phishing scams, seeing a lot of those too.
Yeah, exactly. This is another common one, especially at this point. Like you said, Karen, you know, we're all looking forward to the COVID-19 vaccines coming out next year, and at some point getting to some sense of normality and getting back to the things that we missed so much during this past year, and certainly taking a trip or traveling is probably at the top of the list for a lot of people. So the cyber criminals, that's another area for them to exploit. What they do is they will send an email to someone who has already booked a trip, and they'll tell them that, well, sorry, your trip has been canceled, or there's some kind of problem with your reservation. Please log into your account to correct this. And of course, when you log in, you're giving up your account credentials that the bad guys are able to steal. And there's another related type of scam that GreatHorn discussed in their report here. And this is one where the email promises you a free trip somewhere in exchange for promoting or linking to their page in your social media account. And what happens then is that the link they send you is a link to a malicious website where they're able to install malware or again, try to capture someone's account credentials. So in terms of advice on how to defend yourself against this type of scam, GreatHorn had a couple of recommendations here. Is one thing is to, again, check the sender address on any suspicious emails that you receive to make sure that it sounds right, it sounds accurate. Another thing is when you go to a linked website, make sure that the site is using HTTPS protocol rather than HTTP, or that you see the lock icon in your address field, because that indicates that the site, any information exchanged with the site is encrypted and therefore secure. So that's another good tip. And the other thing basically, and this applies for all of these types of scam, is always double check, always do your research, either search for the topic that's listed in the email or contact the company directly to see if this email is legitimate or if it's actually a scam.
Yeah, definitely some things that, not even things to keep in mind, just we got to be on our toes, right, Lance? I mean, this, yep, this time of year is even more important that we are, because like you said, these phishing scams, they're on the rise, and we're seeing them in take different shapes and forms, all of the time. So definitely got to keep our eyes peeled for these. And again, for phishing scams that we're seeing more and more often here during the holidays, that's what you've been writing about in this piece, but a lot of great tips to keep in mind as we head into this new year. Lance, thanks for being with us today. We hope all of you will check out his article there on Tech Republic, and we appreciate you watching.